हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एट योर होम। एंड इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द रिप्रोडक्शन, टाइप ऑफ द रिप्रोडक्शन, डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन एसेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन एंड सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन, डेफिनेशन ऑफ द लाइफ स्पैन। एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस मोड ऑफ एसेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन। So students, I have made the several type of asexual reproduction. Okay, so firstly drill up after me. First is the fission. Somebody may pronounce fission also, but it is fission, budding, fragmentation, regeneration, spore formation. Okay, spore formation is it is of three types: zoospore, conidia, and gemmules. Yeah, we can say by process gemmulation. And in the next, that is the vegetative propagation: runner, rhizome, sucker, tuber, bulb, bulbils, offset, adventitious bud. Students, if you study this my video, this my class properly, then you don't need to study from other sources also for your board examination. Okay, I can't say this is enough for medical, but it is for enough, more than enough for your class 12th examination. Okay, so first with the fission. So fission means breaking up something, okay, means division of something. So I have one more supporting book. Okay, so that in simple language I can say the division of organisms, yeah, we can say parent organism or parent cell divides into two or more than two cells, and this is called fission. And fission is of two types: binary fission and multiple fission. Binary means, see, there is a word bi means two. So that means when parent body divides into two, only two daughter cells, then it's called binary fission. If parent body or parent cell divides into more than two cells, more than two daughter cells, is called multiple fission. Okay, and the multiple fission example of multiple fission is plasmodium. Okay, and binary fission is again subdivided into three parts. First is the simple binary fission, longitudinal binary fission, and transverse binary fission. Simple binary fission means parent body simply divides into two parts. That is called simple binary fission. This is the example of amoeba. Okay, you all can see the diagram, friends. See, students, this is the nucleus, this is the amoeba divide, this is having a nucleus elongated, nucleus get elongated, see, dividing nucleus, and this is this, and finally in the final diagram, this single amoeba divides into two daughter cells, are two amoebae. Okay, and before I think four or five years ago, there was a question. Okay, and I think it was 2014, the first question of single mark, that was name the organism in which cell division represents a kind of reproduction. So example was fission, or you can say the most appropriate answer was the binary fission. Okay, and the next is the, we talk about the next, longitudinal binary fission. Longitudinal binary fission means when parent body get divided longitudinally means like this. This is the plane of division. This is called longitudinal binary fission. In the other one is the transverse binary fission, means for parent body divided by transversally. This is the plane of division. Okay, an example of transverse, this is the paramecium. Okay, and longitudinal, this is the euglena. Okay, and euglena, you know very well, connecting between living organisms, sorry, plants and animals. Plants and animals. Okay, students, I am just teaching you fast because I don't want this video very large. Okay, note. Okay, sporulation, it is attached in CBSE syllabus, you know, class 12 syllabus in 2013 or I can say 14. Okay, sporulation, it is seen in the amoeba and some more organism. Okay, in unfavorable condition, in unfavorable condition, by a process in cystation. In cystation means formation of three layers around the amoeba, around the amoeba. Okay, and amoeba kept dividing inside the cyst, and when favorable condition comes, cyst gets broken and all the amoebae comes out of the cyst, and they are now able to live individually. So this is the sporulation. Okay, it is not it is given into this word is given in the last of your book. Okay, this is the budding. Budding is it's sometimes it gives giving a sense as bud, formation of bud on parental, yeah, we can say parent organisms, and get separated, and after some time attached to attach somewhere, or if doesn't attach to someone, but it has to develop into a new organism, a new individual. That is the example of this is the yeast, is the yeast and hydra, yeast and hydra. So see students, I have the book also. See, this is a parent cell budding. See, this is a bud and this is mature bud, and it is about to get separated. Okay, in the yeast, and also you can see the same diagram, same example in the hydra also. Okay, but there is no diagram of the hydra. Okay, next, that is very important, fragmentation. It is giving a sense also, fragment, formation of fragment. Parent body breaks into you can also use split. Parent body breaks into two or more fragments, and each fragment form a new individual. Example, spirogyra. Example, Spirogyra, and also in some fungus also. And this type of chloroplast is found in Spirogyra. Anyone can answer me? That is the spiral. Okay, see this diagram also. This diagram is very important. See, this is the main parent body, and getting divided into two parts. This is one part, this is the one part. Okay, so this is the new, these are the new individual. Okay, next is very important, that is the regeneration. Regeneration means it is also giving a sense that regenerate, regrowth of damaged or lost part of the body. Okay, example is the planaria. Highest regeneration capacity, yeah, regenerating capacity in living world. Okay, and the one more thing, that human bodies, there are over one or two organs which having the regeneration capacity. That is the first is the liver. Okay, first is the liver, and second is the kidney. Okay, next is the spore formation. That is the spore formation. Okay, first is the zoospore. Zoospores are especially found in algae. These are the unicellular, naked, means no cell wall present around it. Okay, motile with one or two flagella. Example, Chlamydomonas. And you know, do you recall your previous classes lectures? Chlamydomonas have the cup shape chloroplast, and have a proteinous body, that is called pyrenoid, that is called pyrenoid. That is the conidia. Asexual conidia is the asexual structures, non-motile. Okay, this is also very important. This and I can say fission. These two are so important. And examples are Phytophthora. In your book, it given only Phytophthora. The full name is Phytophthora infestans. Causes the fungal disease called late blight of potato. Late blight of potato means in early stage the the leaves of the potato get damaged by this fungus. Okay, and one more, that is Penicillium notatum. Species is Penicillium notatum. And do you know this word comes in your mind? Then you should come with the answer. First antibiotics produced by this fungus, that is known as penicillin. And in 1928, okay, that is the done by Alexander Fleming. Okay, students, in St. Mary Hospital of London, in St. Mary Hospital of London. Okay, so these are the things. And penicillin doesn't cause any disease, okay, in human beings. It gives some allergical effect, but doesn't cause any disease. Next is the gemmules. Gemmules is the structure. And formation of gemmule by a process, and that process is known as gemmulation. And gemmulation is also known as internal budding. Okay, students, internal budding. Internal asexual reproductive units. Internal asexual reproductive units are buds called gemmules. Okay, example into the sponge. Some of you are have started thinking, I think, what is the sponge? So all the members of Porifera are known as sponges. Students, see, this is the diagram of the zoospores. Okay, in case of Chlamydomonas, Conidia, Penicillium. See, these are the Conidium. Okay, Conidia is the plural, and Conidium is the singular. Conidia is the plural. See, four. I think in all this, 1, 2, 3, 4. Especially, I think four Conidia are produced. Okay, and next is the gemmules. Gemmules are produced by a particular special cell, that's name is amoebocytes. Okay, in the middle layer of all the member of Porifera, in the middle layer of the Porifera, not layer, middle part, I can say. Okay, and next is the students, one more thing. Some of you may get confused at difference between fragmentation and regeneration, because I have been teaching for 9 years, and students have been asking the differences between regeneration and fragmentation. So I am just giving you a clear answer, that fragmentation means parent body fragments into two or more pieces. Okay, but in regeneration, damaged or lost part of the body is achieved, or we can say regenerated. Okay, that is called regeneration. Okay, there in regeneration, body is not going to split, or we can say fragment. So this, see the difference. And the last one mode of the asexual, that is the vegetative propagation, so important. Okay, first there are, and one vegetative propagation means when leaf stem are used, root, stem and leaves are used as a unit to increase its number, and that part of parent part parent plant is known as vegetative propagules, is known as vegetative propagules. This is the unit of unit of vegetative propagation. Propagation means increase the number. Propagation means increase the number. Okay, students. And the first example is the runner. First example is the runner. Runner means I can define it subaerial stem. Subaerial stem. You all have seen the cynodon. Cynodon in Hindi is called dub. Some stems are just at the surface of the soil. Okay, they run on the ground, on the top of the soil. So they are called runner. So these are the subaerial. Some parts are into soil and some parts are on the top of the soil. This rhizome. Rhizome is the underground stem. Underground stem. Example, ginger, turmeric, banana. Okay, these are the examples. Okay, and ginger, turmeric, banana have the nodes. Have the nodes. If stem is underground, okay, then it must have the nodes. So when you bring the ginger at your home in the rainy season, after 3 or 4, or winter season also, after 3 or 4 days, you might have seen the nodes coming on the surface of the ginger, turmeric. Okay, and the sucker. Sucker is also a kind of stem, but oblique stem means it doesn't make 180 degree, make 180 degree with the surface. It's like this, oblique, 30 degree, 70 degree, but not like this. Okay, this is chrysanthemum. Chrysanthemum. Chrysanthemum is a kind of name of the flowering plant. Okay, and mint. Mint means pudina. Next is the tuber. This is also underground stem. An example is the potato. And this is the potato is the stem, because you also have seen it start germinating when you keep in the moist places for 4, 5, 6 days, especially in the month of November and October, because it is the stem, and stem has the nodes. Stem has the nodes, and from nodes, adventitious buds. Sorry, auxiliary buds. Auxiliary buds start arising. Okay. Next is the bulb. Onion is like a bulb. It's like a bulb structure of the bulb. Okay. And so they are called bulb. And onion is the example of this. And garlic. Onion, you all must be knowing. Garlic means lehsun. Garlic means lehsun. Okay. Next is the bulbils. This is the accessory bud. This is the accessory bud. Example is Ageo. Full name is Ageo americana. Okay. So what is the accessory bud? You all have started thinking that sir is just telling me, but not telling the exact thing. See, this is the stem. This is the stem. This is I can say node and node. This is the leaf. This is the leaf. So somewhere this is the terminal bud, and this is the auxiliary bud. And after, apart from this, there is also what comes in some plant in a special case, that is accessory bud. Accessory bud. Okay, so it reserves the food, and after some time this gets broken and form a new plant. That is the offset. Is the offset. Offset. Offset is the subaerial stem. But this is the one more thing, that solen. Okay, for example, this is the node, this is node, that is the C. You all have seen in case of Eucornea, water hyacinth. In Hindi, it's called Jalkhumbi. Okay, you all have seen it having purple flower. This is the exotic plant. This is the exotic plant. Okay, British people came in, brought this in India, brought this in India to grow into their water bodies, in their swimming pool. okay, but it has become problem for India. It is also known as terror of the Bengal. Terror of the Bengal. Next is the adventitious bird. So important. Adventitious bird. When leaves, you know, birds arises, but of many types, as I have told here also, and this is also one kind of adventitious bird. Birds arises at the margin of the leaves, at the margin of the leaves. For example, bryophyllum, and bryophyllum. Can anyone tell me what is the bryophyllum? If I tell you all in Hindi, you all will be get pleased. Okay, Hindi is azuba. Hindi is azuba. See the different diagram of the vegetative propagation. These are the leaves. Or this is offset. Water hyacinth diagram is here. Adventitious root and buds and nodes of the turmeric. This is bryophyllum. This is tuber and this is C. C one is the example of angiosperm, potato tuber, rhizome, build up, bulbil of ageo. Okay, so these are this bulbil is broken from the tree and here uprooted into the not uprooted but representing that it is uprooted, sown into the soil, okay, to make it produce a new plant. Okay students, I hope you all are you all have got this lecture very useful, and if any doubt especially of my school, then you all can answer me in my WhatsApp group, question in my WhatsApp group. I will be ready for you all. Okay, so these are also, I will be giving you all also PDF of these notes also. Okay, and I hope you all have enjoyed it. If any doubt, you may ask your questions in comments sections. So I will attach this PDF also here. Okay, this photo of this notes also. Thanks for watching, and we will meet with the sexual reproduction in the next video. Okay, bye bye, take care.